Name the first 25, and why should you be number 26?
So I have been watching CNN the whole 2 years, and this is a question. And you know, I forgot the first part. What was it?
The first part is, there are many pageants for female impersonators.
Okay. And why should I be Miss Continental?
Continental 2005.
Okay, well, first and foremost, I want to thank Samantha Perez and other people who sponsored me to get in here. And I chose Continental because about 10 or 12 years ago, I was introduced to this contest through my drag mother, Tandy Andrews. And after watching the videos through years, it's such a fabulous contest, and I said, I'm going to be one of those girls one day. I have to do that. I want to be there. I want to be one of the Monicas, Mimi, Cezanne, Candace. I know I can do it. I know that I can. And the reason that I think I should be the next Miss Continental is because about 10 years ago, Tandy, my drag mother, was asked a question similar kind of like to this, why should she be, I think it was Miss National. And part of her answer was, well, she said, I'm going to travel from city to city and state to state. While I'm there, I'm going to plant a seed and watch that seed grow. When Tandy got to San Antonio, she planted a seed there, and that was me. She also said, when I'm not there, you can lean to me. So I leaned on Tandy for a long, long time. And when she was no longer there, then I had to lean on someone else, and that was Mr. Rafael Velasco. So I was kind of going back and forth, and when I lost him, I had nowhere to lean, no one to lean on but myself. So what I decided to do was either quit competing and doing what I love to do the most, or get on my own 2 feet and stand straight by myself with my own backbone holding me up. And I think that tonight, with the package that I presented all by myself, I think that I'm very qualified of being the next Miss Continental.
Slipping fast, oh. preferences of every person at Pepsi-Cola are with you.
Al Steele helped make this company.
And you were right by his side, sharing the burdens and the joy.
And we want to give you ample time to repay the debt. Of course, we'll have to take the Fifth Avenue apartment. You probably wouldn't want to stay there alone anyway.
What debt? I've got 100,000 shares of stock.
Your husband had to borrow against the stock to pay for the construction on your apartment.
And we loaned him a considerable sum in addition to meet expenses his salary didn't cover.
You think you're very clever, don't you? Trying to sweep the poor little widow under the carpet? Well, think again. I'm on the board of directors of this lousy company.
Well, we assumed that with your husband gone, you would no longer want to be on the board.
Al and I helped build Pepsi to what it is today. I intend to stay with it.
We appreciate your devotion and contribution, Miss Crawford, but we have retired you from the board of directors.
You're wasting mine.
I'm not acting. I'm not acting.
You can't take her any place she wants. A fancy club and restaurant. But I can't really watch you with. I know the rest of it again. The window's red.
I don't feel I have anybody. No contract. Studio.
Sometimes when I feel afraid, I think of what a mess I've made of my life. Crying over my mistakes, forgetting all the freak I've had in my life. I was put on earth to be a part of this great world as we.
Steal to his grave, and now you're trying to stab me in the back? Forget it! I fought worse monsters than you for years in Hollywood. I know how to win the hard way.
Miss Crawford, we don't want any hard feelings.
You don't know what hard feelings are until I come out publicly against your product, and you'll see how much you sell.
Please, Miss Crawford, it's hardly necessary to make threats you surely don't mean.
Don't fuck with me, fellas! First time at the rodeo. You forget the press I delivered to Pepsi was my power. I can use it any way I want. It's a sword. Cuts both ways.